Morgan Pressel had unprecedented success on the golf course at a very young age. But assuming it was a fairy tale run to the tour, that's far from the truth. Pressel qualified for her first major at the age of 12 and played the U.S. Open at 13, both records at the time. But just 2 years later, her mom, Catherine, died of breast cancer. She moved here to Boca Raton to live with her grandparents and polished her game at nearby St. Andrews. She's recorded 63 top 10 finishes since turning pro, but more importantly, has raised more than $9.5 million to fight the disease that took her mother's life. So you grew up less than 7 miles from here at St. Andrews. How does it feel to be basically coming home and helping to bring a LPGA tournament to your hometown?
I think it's awesome. I think it's really cool. It's the first time since I've been a fan of the LPGA since I was a youngster that we've ever played in Boca Raton. I think it's the first time the LPGA has ever played in Boca Raton. And you know, to think that I had a small part in helping bring the event here to a course that I certainly love here at Boca Rio and kind of trying to bring all the pieces together. I was a youngster who used to love to go to the LPGA events in the area, and there hasn't been any for a long time. So hopefully we get a lot of good young fans out this week and introduce some new faces to the game. The young kids are the future of the sport. They're the ones who will carry the torch long after I'm done playing golf. And to think, you know, that we're in a position now that, I mean, previous generation certainly inspired me, and to think that I'm kind of in that position now, we all are, to inspire the next generation, it's a good place to be.
Ever cross your mind that you were going to be qualifying for the U.S. Open at 13 when you were like 7, 8, 9 years old?
No, even when we were getting ready to go to the qualifier, and I asked my grandfather, like, oh, what tournament is this, you know, we're playing in today? And he's like, oh, it's the U.S. Open qualifier. And I was like, what? Yeah. Why am I playing in that? He's like, oh, we're just playing for experience, no big deal. And then I went out and won the thing. And all of a sudden, I'm playing in the U.S. Open. So it was definitely a shock to me even as well. But, I mean, I guess it shows if you don't throw yourself out there, you never really know where you stand. And it was obviously a fabulous experience, and that was when I really decided that I wanted to make golf a career. That was when I said, this is what I want to do.
Now the philanthropic part of the story, which is really important, obviously. Your mom died of breast cancer way too early. Devastating impact on you. What helped you get through that?
Yeah, I'd say golf helped me get through that. You know, my mother passed away when I was 14, 15, and it was, I was a high schooler, you know, it's a tough time for any young lady. My sister and my brother, both younger than me as well, so it was definitely a difficult time for our family. But I remember from right away, I said, I just want to get back on the golf course, because that was kind of my place where I could focus on something else. It could take my mind off of it instead of, you know, sitting at home and feeling that void.
The legacy is the Morgan Pressel Foundation.
Yeah, our foundation, we've had a golf tournament. I mean, I happen to play golf, so it works out that
way. Good idea, by the way.
Yeah, you know, golf is such a natural in terms of raising money, especially charitable funds. So about 13 years ago, some friends at St. Andrews Country Club and I got together, and we wanted to do something. We wanted to raise money for, in honor of my mother, for breast cancer, to help other families going through similar things to what my family went through. And lo and behold, we kind of threw some ideas at the wall, came up with a golf tournament, and 13 years later, we've raised $9.5 million that all goes right back here to South Florida. We do a lot with Boca Raton Regional Hospital. We have a mammography van that travels all around Palm Beach County, all over South Florida, really. Center for Cancer Genetics, and then we also work with Sylvester Cancer Center on a drug research program. So we've been very involved, especially here in South Florida. These are all areas where my mom was treated, places that she went to visit doctors and for chemotherapy. So it's you never know. It might be some centers that me, my family, our friends might need someday. So it's
and as important, everybody else in the community.
Everybody.
And the real story here is you conceptualized this when you were 18 years old, basically.
I look back at that and I don't really know how it happened. I say I had incredible people, friends who really helped us move that along and really helped get it off the ground. I think I maybe, you know, came up with an idea, I want to do something, but they made it happen. And, you know, especially with St. Andrews Country Club, what they've done for 13 years to just, it keeps getting bigger and better, our events, and we've been able to raise over $1 million now for the last 5 years. So each year, it's pretty special. It's the most amazing day for me of the year is to see the support of our community for what I believe in, a passion that's really near and dear to my heart, and that they all believe in what we're trying to do and what we're trying to accomplish fighting breast cancer right here in South Florida.
I've been rehearsing this all day, so let me try it. The mobile medical mammography vehicles.
Nailed it.
I was close. On behalf of Catherine Crickstein. So obviously you talked about it a little bit.
Yeah, you know, it's actually something that I even just learned is that our van, which is named the Catherine Crickstein Pressel Mammo Van in honor of my late mother, it's a really special vehicle. It has all of the exact same mammography equipment that you'd get in the hospital, the 3D mammography, the same radiologist would read your scans, and they get you your results right away through Boca Raton Regional Hospital. And it's one of actually only 5 mammovans in all of North America. So that is kind of an impressive stat for us that our van has generated a lot of interest in other people wanting to do the same thing, which is only going to help more people. So it's awesome.
I guess finally, your 63 top 10 finishes, that's wonderful, and nobody makes light of it. But when you look back, the things that you're doing right now to develop a legacy on behalf of your mom and to raise $30 million for cancer research, that really is something to live with, I'm sure, and I'm sure you're incredibly proud of that.
Well, thank you. Yeah, it's definitely something that I'm proud of, and I hope it's something that definitely continues long after my golf career, the actual golf part of my career takes a back seat. So.
The actual golf part of her career is
not, yet,
not over. It's not over. There are many more majors to live, and I'm not going to, she's not going to say it, I'm going to say it, but the legacy is firmly in place. Morgan Pressel, thank you very much.
Thank you, Rick.